I'm gonna ask everybody to have a circle on the altar, please. And I want you to chant with me. Odin, Vili, Ve. Odin, Vili, Ve. Odin, Vili, Ve. Odin, Vili, Ve. How many notary have you attended the occult board? How many ostri have you attended the occult board? How many sudri have you attended the occult board? How many vestri have you attended the occult board? How many ifrimi have you attended the occult board? How many unimi have you attended the occult board? Hammer, Haggadetta, Occult Board. Today we return gift for gift by honoring Thor in our words and deeds. I asked all of you to bring like a poem, song, something you would like to go ahead. I'll start with a poem called Son of Lightning. Great men and humble sons of Heimdall, by Odin's will I speak of recent lore. Of a friend of Thor whom I remember, once a friend told a tale, one of troubled brow and hopeful faith, with ring on heart and hope and stay of turmoil. Hands in the sky, he asked his mighty God. He thus spoke with heart racing, before the gods, all the nine worlds, facing the skull of Ymir. Thunderer, give me a sign of your strength. He then spoke with set on his brow, into the halls of the great Gilskimer. And Thor listened intently. Is this faith of me, God of Thunderer? Then he slept on that clear night, one of troubled brow and hopeful faith, with ring on heart and hope in sad turmoil. Asa Thor thought, looked in the men's pure heart. Then Thor leaped out on the clear night. He of troubled brow, but shining heart, racing his goats, his chariot burning. Across the skies, racing for his beloved son. Hammer high, smashing Jotun, who blocked his pathway to his beloved son. Gap-tooth raced hard. Tooth-gnasher raced harshly. Mighty son of Yor, racing for his beloved son. Thunder claps, lightning crashes. Morning sun, he beat to his beloved son. Swinging hammer, collecting his right might. Lord of Lightning gave his love to his son. Powerful, lightning crash. Oak tree split in half, ode to his son. Presence left there, pre-meeting the night. Lord of Lightning showing his love to his son. Son awoke, heart full of joy. His God signed so pure on a clear night. Presence felt there, pre-meeting his heart. Son of Lightning was shown his father's love.
This is a poem that's more
Demons run when a good man goes to war. Knights will fall and drown the sun when a good man goes to war. Friendship dies and true love lies. Night will fall and the dark will rise when a good man goes to war. Demons run, but count the cost. The battle is won, but the child is lost.
It's a poem that I connect with. It's called The Raven. On my shoulder, a raven rests. Her talons pierce my skin. As I hold her weight, no one sees the raven. I hide her very well. The raven can never fly away. She is bound to me. The raven wants to be seen, be heard. She screeches beside my ear. She drives away my sanity. The raven has been with me for a while now. At first, she was small and barely noticeable. As time went on, the raven grew. Her size grew along with her strength and also her desperation. The raven wants to be free. She wants to fly away to someplace else, to some, and leave behind. Why did the raven come? Why can't the raven leave? Is the raven even real? Am I insane? I am the raven, she is me, I am she, and the raven is me.
Unfortunately, no, we did not. That's fine.
Anybody else?
Son of fury, father of strength, child of all bearing earth, Mjolnir's master, Midgard's shield, warding of whites and worth. Courage, your hammer, and confidence glove, valor the staff you wield. Bravery, your belt, thundering Thor, fiercely holding the field. Greatest gods, grant us your grit, be near, wielder of power, that we meet life in all its strife, head on in every hour.
I have a Robbie Burns poem, The Fall of the Leaf. The laziness hangs from the brow of the hill, concealing the course of the dark winding rill. How languid the scenes, late so sprightly appear, as autumn to winter resigns the pale year. The forests are leafless, the meadows are brown, and all the gay frobbery of summer is flown. Apart from me wander, apart from me muse, how quick time is flying, how keen fate pursues. How long have I lived, but how much lived in vain, how little of life's scanty span may remain. What aspects of old time in his progression has worn, what ties cruel fate in my bosom has torn. How foolish or worse till our summer is gained, and downward how weakened, how darkened, how pained. Life is not worth having with all it can give, for something beyond it poor man must shall live.
So I would like to read a little excerpt poem for Thor, from the book Gods and Country from the Fenians of Yorkshire. Prayer to Thor by Protector of Man in Asgard by Keith Leo. Hail Thor, protector of the gods and of Asgard, protector of men and their home of Midgard, traveler, wanderer, seeker of justice, destroyer of Jotnar, searcher for the Midgard serpent, son of the Valfather, strongest of the gods, Thor, worthy of wielding Mjolnir, enabling the destruction of numerous giants, husband of Sif, goddess with the beautiful golden hair, traveling companion of Loki, the blood brother, sometimes quick to anger, especially when concerning Jotuns or Loki, wearing the great belt of strength Mingingjord and of Jarngreipnir, the iron gloves that help wield Mjolnir. Hail to Thor, the red-haired, red-beard god of thunder, the god of lightning. Lover of Yarn Saxa, the one Jotun Thor will not destroy with Mjolnir. With Yarn Saxa, you begot Magni, survivor of Ragnarok. Hail to Thor, god, warrior, and protector. We leave you this offering as a thank you. We leave this offering freely with the greatest intentions. We thank you, Thor, and we hope this offering pleases you.
Anybody else? Anybody share? Thank you. Okay, four rounds. Hail Thor!
Hail Thor!
Hail to the ancestors.
Hail to the ancestors.
This is open. Anybody want to hail to?
Hail Tyr.
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 Anyone else?
Hail to Odin.
Oh,
hail to Odin.
Anyone else? Hail to the wolves of the North Kindred.
Hail to the wolves of the North Kindred.
I'd like to hail to my grandmother, who has been there for me, giving me very sound advice through life and through death. And I'd also like to hail my patron, Halogi, the god of fire.
Hail.
So, as the wolves in the North Kindred start to grow, we've been now 4 years, and we attract other kindreds like the Iron Wolves. So today, we're going to oath in the Iron Wolves to be part of the Wolf and North Kindred. Jarl is a noble Norse warrior known for his strength and intelligence. According to Norse legend, Heimdall disguised himself as a human named Rib and leaves his post in the gateway to Asgard, where he is guarding the gods that travel the earth where he fathered 3 children. In early Norse history, Jarls were regional, but over time, as they expanded and consolidated power, they grew on being national leaders. The role of Jarl could be hereditary or used by military leaders. They were not revered as the British did their kings, but they were considered the most able and strongest of men. What would you call yourself?
Bond of Iron.
Jarl Bond of Iron would accept the position of Jarl as the most public.
Absolutely.
We welcome you. Now, oath to your members.
Before we end this bloat, I'd like to ask Courtney to stand forward. You have told me you are ready to join this kindred. Is that so?
Yes.
Do you fully understand our rules, our customs, and what we will be expected, or what will be expected of you as a member of our kindred?
Yes, sir.
I advocate that you, Courtney, be admitted as a member of our kindred. Does anybody else here have any objections? No objections having been raised, or all objections having been satisfied, Courtney, I ask you now to repeat after me before Vaughn. And all the gods and goddesses, I swear that from this day hence.
I swear that from this day hence.
Until my death or my release from this oath.
Until my death or release from this oath.
I shall be honorable and loyal.
I shall be honorable and loyal.
To this kindred.
To this kindred.
I shall help its members and consider them as my brothers and sisters.
I shall help its kindred and consider them as my brothers and sisters.
I shall honor the gods and goddesses of the Norse according to our ways.
I shall honor the gods and goddesses of the Norse according to our ways.
Which god or goddess do you ask to take witness?
Mine.
Which ancestor do you ask to take witness?
My great-grandmother, Mother.
I, Jarl, Bonded Iron, of the Wolves of the North Kindred and Council, accept you as kin and honor the oath you have taken here today in front of our kin, friends, ancestors, and the gods. You will be treated with honor, respect, and firth as you will treat the kindred in the same fashion.
Thank you.
Asa Thor, your presence here today has been well received by your folk. May our words and deeds bring honor unto you and all of your godly kin. May the might of Mjolnir reward those gathered here, as well as those kinmen far flung, as we wend our way through Midgard. As this rite draws to a close, know you're welcome amongst us as we feast and we celebrate the joys of fellowship. Hail Thor, friend of man.
Hail Thor, friend of man.
Hail Thor, protector of Asgard.
Hail Thor, protector of Asgard.
Hail Thor. From the gods to the earth, to us, from us to the earth, to the gods. Give her a gift. The rite has ended. Hail. Now, let's see what you guys...